Hello students, so just 2 days ago I had made a video on the brief of PGCET. So what I thought was let's solve 2019 question paper PGCET Civil so that you will get some idea on the weightage of the subjects which were asked in that paper. Okay, so by solving this question paper 2019 PGCET, okay, so that doesn't mean that the pattern remains same for this year also. But tentatively, that is, we have done the analysis of previous papers also from 2017, 18, 19. So all 3 years when we compared, we found out something like some subjects have very high weightage and the weightage of that remains the same for the previous years. For example, if you say environmental engineering, so the weightage of this is around 12 marks. See, it can be 11 marks or 13 marks or 14 marks. But it will never be 5 marks or 20 marks like that. So that is how we found here. Okay, and this 2019 question paper is not available in the internet. If you want to go through this 2019 PGCET question paper, visit www.sandpoint.co.in website. So here we have uploaded the previous year question paper. Go through that. Do some analysis and then start preparing accordingly. Okay, so as per our analysis, what we found was, okay, I'm just telling you what we found in the previous year paper. Building materials questions on building materials were asked for 3 marks. Okay, so the various building materials are stones, bricks, aggregates, clay materials, tiles, cement, concrete and all. But till now I haven't found a single question on concrete. I think only one test question was there, but no properties, admixtures, whatever you study, right? All the tests, no question was there. And you can expect questions from bricks more in this building material. Next comes your environmental engineering. In gate also it is having 12 to 14 marks weightage. Here also it is almost same. Okay, and in other government exams also you are having high weightage. So here you can expect the questions right from the first chapter, that is water demand. Calculate the water demand, sources of water, then what are the water quality parameters, different tests, standard units. Next comes your water treatment. Next comes distribution system. This is what is your water supply. Next comes your sewage, collection of the sewage, different tests, all the BOD, COD. Next comes your sewage treatment, disposal, so all that entire air pollution, noise pollution. And remember one thing in this, in GATE as well as in other question papers, since recent years questions on air pollution and noise pollution are appearing more. Though you need to study very less, like hardly 3 to 4 pages for air pollution and 2 to 3 pages for noise pollution, but still the questions are appearing on this, around 12 marks weightage. Next comes your railway engineering. This year it was asked, okay, 2019 for 1 mark. Surveying it was asked for 1 mark here. But when I analyzed 2018 paper, 17 paper, 16 paper, so more than 5 marks were asked from this topic. More than 5 marks from surveying. So you can expect more number of questions from this year. So what are the topics again here in this? The very first is your linear measurement, that is chain surveying, theodolite, leveling, then comes photogrammetry, okay, some parts of the total station, curve setting, plane table surveying. So all these questions you can expect from all these topics in surveying. Like you can expect at least one question from chain surveying. Okay, then contours, so all these topics are included here. Okay, so I will be solving questions on this now. Okay, after the explanation of the completely pattern scheme, I'll be explaining questions on these topics, and these topics will be considered by Anchit sir, who will be solving questions on this. See, Geotech again 11 marks. Okay, compared to previous years also the weightage remains the same. Okay, so you can consider environmental engineering. Okay, then geotech engineering, where you will get almost stable marks. Okay, in different papers, almost stable marks. There is no much fluctuation. Next, in highway engineering, around 8 marks. Irrigation, 7 marks. Hydrology 2, OCF 2, PSC RCC 11, SA 1, steel 9 marks. Okay, so again these are little stable, that is highway irrigation is also little stable. So these topics on this questions on these topics will be solved by Anchit sir. Next, on SOM and FM. Yeah, so these are again very very important weightage all together. Okay, these two topics together constitutes 25 marks. Remember that your entire question paper is of 100 marks. So 25 marks itself is FM and SOM, and the same way weightage of this is same for other exams also. Okay, so you can consider these subjects also as the major one. Okay, some analysis, because why I am doing this analysis, see, if you are able to study all the subjects now, whatever I have written here, 2 plus 8 10 plus 4 14 subjects. So if you are able to study 14 subject before August 8th 2020, then that is really good. Okay, but if you are not able to study, you have to pick the subjects very wisely. Do not start with the subject which is having very less weightage. Hydrology is very easy, ma'am. I will start with hydrology, but it will come for around 2 marks. Okay, even if it comes for more, 5 marks, not more than that. Okay, so that is how you have to do wise selection in the subjects when you are choosing and when you are having less time. If you are having more time, I always suggest you to prepare for 100 marks, always. Okay, so I will be solving, Anchit sir will be solving, Narottam sir will be solving question. Now coming to the package, what we are offering for the student is, this package is completely online, that is, it is not a live classroom. We have made the recorded videos of these subjects. We are considering it as a one package now. Other than this, other subjects are also there, but considering the weightage, whatever I have marked, okay, FM, SOM, Environment, Geotech. So these together, these all four subjects consist of your 50% weightage in the exam. Okay, around 50% weightage in your PGCET. Even if you consider other exams, okay, the reason why I am talking about other exams also is, when you are preparing for one subject, you should be ready for other exams also. Do not just target for this exam, and whatever the paper pattern is there for PGCET, for our state level government exams, it is little same, but little bit difficulty side in the state level exams, and GATE is above all actually. Okay, so now these are very important. So along with this, these four subjects are there. We have also added irrigation, building materials, concrete technology and surveying. See, this subject, then this subject, this. See, all these are there in the PGCET, whatever it is there. Okay, I am talking about our package. We are giving you the package of 10 subjects. Okay, so these subjects are there. But along with that, we have given you some 3 extra subjects also. Extra subjects also. That doesn't mean that we are wasting your time. So what I am suggesting students now is, if you buy the package, it is valid for 1 year. If you buy it today, so it is 20th June 2020. Okay, so it is valid till 20th June 2021. Whatever the videos you are purchasing. So what I am telling such students is, who are buying package for PGCET is, you study these subjects first, whatever we have marked here, leave these subjects, okay, and once you get notification, you can study these, because the videos are valid for 1 year. Also, the students who are preparing for SSC JEE, who have applied for SSC JEE 2020, September 1st is the exam. Okay, September 1st is the prelims exam of SSC JEE. So when you consider SSC JEE, you can expect lot and lot of questions on STM and on estimation and on building materials. So estimation and building materials constitutes minimum 30% weightage. Hope I am not confusing you guys. Okay, I am just telling you that SSC exam is not far. And I know many students have applied for this exam. Just it is September 1st, after 2 months. Okay, so your PGCET exam is in August. So just less than 20 days gap you are having SSC JE. So during that gap you can prepare for these subjects, because whenever we are charging for the package, we charge subject wise. If we add 5 more subjects to it, the pricing will be more. If we reduce the subjects, the pricing will be less. Okay, so we have made the package of this, which is having multiple advantages, and also whatever the package we are giving now, it is as per the standards of all your government exams. It is not just PGCET, because we cannot keep making separate videos for PGCET, for RRB, for SSC and all, because theory remains the same for all the exams, just the numerical part is different. Okay, so if you buy these subjects, this will take care of your government exams as well. Remember this. So do not consider that I need to buy some other videos of the same FM for PWD and all. No, once you purchase, they are valid for 1 year and all your exams will be taken care. I am meaning as all, okay, all your PWD, irrigation, SSC JE, RRB, then PGCET, okay, any other notifications like BBMP, BWSSB, KPTCL, KPCL, if you get any, all the exams are taken care by the videos which we are providing. So once you complete these subjects, so you can contact ma'am before August, like if you are able to complete these subjects by July last week. So if you contact us back, ma'am, I want 2 more subjects to study, then we will give you highway, because it is having more weightage, and along with that we can give you RCC also. Okay, see, because RCC and highway together constitutes around 20 marks, okay, 18 to 20 marks weightage. So we can add these 2 subjects to this list later on. Understood? So I will be solving the questions on this now. So we'll solve the questions on building materials for the year 2019 PGCET question paper. Okay, so 3 questions were asked on building materials, 2 questions itself were on brick, and this question is on timber. So let's see the question. In the process of brick manufacturing, the pug mill is used in which of the following operation? Okay, so there are different steps in the manufacturing of the bricks. Okay, so the first one is your unsoiling. Okay, that is taking the earth, cleaning the earth, digging, then weathering, then blending, then tempering. Okay, so before this you can add here cleaning. So there are various stages of preparing the brick earth during the manufacture of the brick. So what is the process of unsoiling? It is the cleaning of the ground first, after that digging the soil, okay, and removing up of the top surface area of around 10 cm of the soil, which is called as removing. Then below that the soil is dug, after that the soil is cleaned, then it is spread on the ground surface for weathering. After that blending is done. Here what is the meaning of blending? They will test the soil, and if you need some other properties to be added, chemicals, color, whatever it is, that is done here. That is the process called as blending. And the next process is called as tempering, which is the meaning of adding water plus kneading. Adding water plus kneading. What is the meaning of kneading? You hit naati vala now. So that is the process called as kneading. That is adding water and making it into a soft mass, so that this mass, whatever the soil you will get, that will be used for the manufacturing of the brick. And this tempering, whatever adding of water and kneading is done, it is done in a pug mill. The device will be something like this. Here some rotator will be there, so which keeps rotating, and they will add soil here and water here. So it can be machine driven or it can be animal driven. So it keeps rotating and the mixing and kneading happens here. So that's why this process is called as tempering. That is the process in which what exactly happens in this pug mill. So in pug mill, the tempering happens. That is, this is called as pug mill now. So here adding, they will add water and they will knead. What is burning? So once this is done, after that they will cast, they will dry, after that they will burn in kilns. That process is called as burning. Weathering is this process, blending is this process. Okay, understood? This question is from brick. Next one, efflorescence of bricks is due to, again the next question is on brick only, is due to soluble salts present in the clay for making bricks, or excessive burning of bricks, or high porosity of bricks, or high silt content of bricks. Try answering this question. See, when we are solving this 2019 question paper, I think you haven't prepared yet for this exam. So if you are able to answer as many questions correct, then you will come to know, like without preparing also, how, to what extent you are able to approach the questions in the exam. Okay, so what is the meaning of efflorescence here? Formation of white patches on the surface of the brick. You might have seen that white patchy surface on the brick, that is called as efflorescence, and there are many efflorescent tests also for the bricks, which you will be studying in the different tests of bricks. Okay, so why this efflorescence happens actually? High silt content in brick, is this because of that? No, because the silt content should be around 20 to 35%. If it is more than that, then your strength reduces. See, this is how we tell the students to write notes in our class. Strength reduces, instead of write like that, strength reduces, strength increases like this, so that you will remember the things easily. So it is wrong. Next, does efflorescence happens because of high porosity of bricks? No, because if the bricks is having high porosity, then water absorption will be more, as well as the strength of that brick will be less. Next, excessive burning of brick. What happens if the brick is overburnt? It will change its rectangular shape, as well as it will change its reddish brown color to black color. So even this is not the cause for efflorescence. If you consider first option, soluble salts present in the clay. Yes, because of this, the efflorescence happens in the brick. Because, see, you might be knowing, clay is the basic ingredient of the brick. Manno, mud, black cotton soil. So that is the basic ingredient of the brick. So if it is having more salts, that salt will come out due to time, and hence that will form a white patches on the surface of the brick. Okay, next question. Wood preservative creosote is derived from. So this question is from chapter timber. Okay, so last topic, you will be studying like different types of methods of the preservative of the wood, like applying oil paint, applying certain chemicals, zinc chloride. Many methods are there for preserving the timber for longer time. So even one of the method is called as, is by using creosote oil. Okay, so this method is called as Bethel's process. See, when they have asked you question on this, next time you can expect the question on, if the wood preservatives is used as creosote, what this process is called as? Bethel's process. Okay, I think this was asked in PWD also. So now, what this creosote is derived from? So either it is derived from acidic cupric chromate, pentachlorophenol, wood and coal, chromated zinc chloride. So this creosote is derived from burning of wood and coal. Okay, this creosote oil, whatever is used as a chemical preservative for the wood, is derived from wood and coal. Okay, so you can read one of the comment in Google reviews. One of the student gave the comment as, if you don't want to mug MCQs, then attend class. What is the meaning of that? What you people will do, you will visit many MCQs website like study.org, IndiaBits, Sand Foundry, all those, and you will just remember the things. Okay, wood preservative, creosote, it is wood and coal, that's it. But if they twist something in the exam, you should be able to answer. That is the way how you have to study the individual subjects. Okay, we will take the next question now. So next question is on rails or railways in transportation engineering. Okay, on broad gauge, a sleeper density of m plus 4 means number of sleepers to be used per kilometer length is. So you know that these are the rails. Okay, and on this sleepers are placed like this. So how many sleeper density is that only. When we call density, so it is the population density, it is number of people in one particular area or some meter square area, so that is called as density. So same way here the rail is lengthwise, so for that length how many sleepers you are using, that is the meaning. Listen, on broad gauge a sleeper density of m plus 4 means number of sleepers to be used per kilometer length is. So in fact this is aptitude question, still you haven't prepared for this one, you should be able to answer. But one thing what you have to remember is rail length. So now what is this m plus 4 we have they have given, right? So what is this m? It is one rail length. So for broad gauge it is 13 meter, okay, that is the individual rail length. If it is meter gauge, narrow gauge, the length the rail length of that is less than 13 meter. So m is that. So what now they are saying, so m plus 4 is the number of sleepers which we will be there for this much meter. So what I can write, for 13 meters of rail length, how many sleepers will be there? M plus 4 sleepers. And for per kilometer how many sleepers will be there? So now this is in meter, so we have to take this in meters. So how many sleepers will be there? So 13 meter is to, what is this m? It is the rail length, so it is 13 plus 4, okay, 1000 meters into xx. So 13 meter is to 17 sleepers, then 1000 meters is to how many sleepers? So it is sleepers is equal to 17 into 1000 divided by 13. So meter will get cancelled, this will remember. So 17,000 divided by 13 will give you option A, 1308 sleepers are needed per kilometer of rail length. So this is how you have to calculate. Okay, again this is a favorite question, questions on this have come in many exams. So we'll solve numerical questions which was asked from environmental in the same paper. Okay, so all three are 2 mark questions. Now usually the numericals are asked in 2 mark section of your PGCET question paper. So now let's take the question. Population of the year 2000, okay, in the year 2000 of a city whose population in 1930 was this much and in 1970 was 47,000. Use geometrical increase method. See what they are asking you, they have given you the corresponding population of 1930. In the year 1930 it was 25,000, in 1970 it was 47,000, and you have to find the population for this particular year using geometric method. So this is what the question is asked, and this question is from water demand topic of your first one, that is water supply. Okay, so now let's start one. So you know like there are different methods to calculate the water demand, that is geometrical increase method, incremental increase method, decremental decrease method, exponential method, arithmetic method. So the various formulae are there, you have to remember the formula. See what you have to understand is this year if they have asked question from geometric method, there are high chances that the question can come from other methods in the next topic. See when we are solving any numerical in the class, we see to it that whatever near end there are there along with these questions what we are solving, we will be telling you that also, ki concentrate on this, there can be some change in this. So we keep telling the students that in our regular class. So now what is the formula for this? So here you have to find the population for the year 2000 and the last year, you have to consider the last year which is given, that is 1970, and the formula for geometric increase method is 1 plus r raised to n. So write the formula first what they are asking. Now in the year 1970 it is 47,000, 1 plus, so do you know r value, that is rate of increase? No, see obviously the population is increasing here, we don't know the r value, so keep it as r. Now what is this n? N is in the decades between these two values whatever you are taking here. So what is the decade gap? It is 70, 80, 90, 2000, that is 30 years are the gap here between these two. So for 30 years, this we are taking as decade. So your n will be 3. Now r is unknown, that is rate of increase. So there are different methods to find the r. There are 3 to 4 methods. Okay, but for the exam purpose, when two populations are given like this, you will be using this formula, p2 by p1 minus 1. Okay, so now let's leave this n as of now. P2 is your last population, that is 47. 0, 0 I'll cancel here itself, minus divided by 25 minus 1. So most of the students take this root completely till here. That is wrong. This root is only for this part. Now what is this n? It is the decade gap between these two populations. So what is the decade gap? Here it is 30, here it is 70, 40 years gap. 40 years means 4. Okay, so now calculate using calculator. So if you calculate, you will get the answer as 0.17 or 17% increase. Okay, now substitute the value here, 1 plus 0.17 raised to 3. So once you calculate, you will get the answer as 75,459. Okay, this question is from one of the years of IES. So that's why we suggest you people ki when you are writing for PWD or PGCET, whatever it is, have a glance on previous year's GATE and IES questions. Understood? This is the answer. Coming to next question. The BOD test, in BOD test, 1 ml of raw sewage was diluted to 100 ml and DO of the diluted sample at the beginning was 6 ppm and it was 4 ppm at the end of 5-day incubation at 20 degrees Celsius. Find the BOD of the raw sewage. So what is this method actually? Finding the BOD of any particular sewage. Okay, like you keep take the water, you aerate the water, then you keep in the incubation tank maintaining 20 degrees Celsius for 5 days. After that, carry out the BOD, dissolved oxygen present in that. From that you will be able to find the BOD. The same experimental procedure is given in the form of the numerical here. So when you are finding 5 days BOD at 20 degrees Celsius, so this is the standard. If the temperature given is different, then you have to use another formula and find the relation and then find out BOD at 5 days 20 degrees Celsius. So DO initial minus DO final into dilution factor. So this is the formula which you are using to find the BOD of the raw sewage. Okay, see, in this question is from the quality parameters of the sewage, that is exactly before your sewage treatment plant, because when you are allowing the sewage in the sewage treatment plant, you need to know the BOD, that is how much quantity of the oxygen is needed. Because if the BOD of the sewage is high and if you just allow that waste straight away in the water resource, that time lot of oxygen will be consumed from the river for the decomposition of this organic matter, because of which the dissolved oxygen in the water will reduce, and if it reduces less than 4 ppm, then there is a threat in aquatic life, that is the aquatic life, fishes and all will die if the dissolved oxygen is less than 4 ppm. So that is the reason the BOD is very, very important of the sewage. That was the theory part. Okay, now DO initial. So what is the DO initial? 6. DO final, it is 4. See, always DO initial is more, because dissolved oxygen in the sample, okay, before you are keeping that in the incubation chamber, you are aerating it and putting it. So that is the reason DO initial will be more. And DO final, what is the DO final? After 5 days, the complete decomposition takes place. So the oxygen content in that sewage will be less always. So remember this, do not write as final minus initial. Okay, so it is initial minus final. And what is the dilution factor? The quantity of the water which is to its diluted, that is was diluted to, so that is this one, and divided by the original quantity of the sample you are taking. So original is 1 ml. Okay, so it is 2 into 100, that is 200 ppm parts per million, or it is milligram per liter. See, if you practice more questions on this, the reason why I am explaining this in detail is, if you are not aware, I am just giving you the points. But in exam, you will not be having this much time. So you should see to it that just check out the values, and they will be easily solved without using calculator also. So just check out the values, 100 by 1, it will be 100. So 6 minus 4, 2, 2 into 100 will be 200. Tick mark straight away. Okay, and that you will get by practice, don't worry. Next one, for the same solid contents, if the quantity of the sludge with moisture content of 97% is x liters, then the quantity of the sludge with moisture content of 94% is what? See now, for the same solid, see they are saying, so this is the x quantity of the solid now, and it is having moisture content of 97%. So you need to find the another value. Okay, what is its volume? Okay, liter or meter cube. What is its volume if the moisture content is 94%? So you have to remember, in the sewage, 99.9% will be water only. Okay, there the water or the moisture content will be high. In our sewage treatment plant, our main aim is to reduce the bulk, that is the quantity of the sewage which is going out from the sewage treatment plant. So what is, how you are reducing? You are taking out the moisture content from that. Okay, and this topic, that is sludge, whatever it is there, it is, this question is appeared from the sewage treatment plant, that to the part of sludge digestion. So there, in sludge digestion, all the moisture, whatever it is there, is removed out. So now this is the question, a volume of sewage is there, it is having 97% of the water. What is that quantity of the sewage which will be having 94%? So now a simple relation is there, VA 100 minus PA is equal to VB 100 minus PB. So what is the meaning of this? It is the volume of a sludge and percentage of the moisture content, volume of the second sludge, percentage of the moisture content, or you can say after treatment, its volume and its moisture content. So now, what is the volume of A they have given? X. So 100 minus PA is 97%. So VB, it is unknown. So it is 100 minus PB, that is 94%. Correct? Trito? Okay, next. So this X into 3 is equal to VB into 6. So 3 ones are 3 twos are VB is equal to X by 2. So your answer is B. What does this mean now? Ignore bare. Just 3% moisture content kami aithe idarkinta. But still your volume gets reduced by half of the quantity. So that is how the moisture content greatly impacts the volume of the sewage. Okay, understood? So these are the questions which appeared from environmental engineering. Next, one question has been appeared from survey. We will solve that. Okay, so now we'll solve a question on the surveying which has appeared in this paper. Okay, but you can see only one question was asked from 2019. But if you see the previous year's question papers, like that is 18, 17, 16, 3 to 4 questions were appeared from this subject, surveying. So there are high chances that in this paper you will be getting more questions. So study this subject carefully. Now let's solve the question. This was asked for 2 mark only, so only one question was appeared. So two distances of 50 meter and 80 meter were accurately measured out, and at the intercepts on the staff between the outer stadia webs were 0.496 at the former distance and 0.796 at the latter. The tachyometric constants are, so what are these tachyometric? When you see this question has been appeared from the chapter tachyometry, wherein you will be able to find the distance between the instrument and the object, as well as you can find the staff reading and the tachyometric constant. When you see the tachyometric word, you should remember this formula, D equal to KS plus C. Now if you see here, this D is the distance, that is the distance when you place the tachymeter here you will keep the staff. So this distance is D. Okay, so this distance is in meter, K is your multiplying constant, and C is your additive constant. So these two are the constants of the tachyometry. So if you see the options, you have to understand that is, this is K, this is C, always you have to remember that. Now what is this S? It is the staff reading, whatever you have got. Okay, usually the manufacturers of the tachyometer will be given you the constant, but sometimes in the exam they will be asking this. Okay, now when you calculate, if you get the S value as 100 and C value as 0, then that time the condition is called as analytic telescope or analytic tachyometer. Remember just that term. What is the condition when the tachyometric is called as analytic tachyometer? If S is 100, C is 0. Now let's solve. So now distances are given. It is 50 meter and another distance is 80 meter. So now you need to find K value. What is S staff reading? 0.496. Here it is 0.796. So C values are unknown. So you can solve as a simultaneous equation. So now it is minus 30. Then if you subtract here, KK will get cancelled and your CC will get cancelled. So here KK is there. So here you are remaining with 0.3K. Now again you can cancel this minus value. So it is 30 by 0.3. Just shift one zero here. Shift the decimal here. Then shift one zero here. So it is K value 100. So from the calculation, you got K value as 100. So you can see the option here. So it is option C because K value is 100. Without calculating next, you can tick mark the option so that you can save time. But still, if two options have 100 in that, here also 100, here also 100, then what you will do? You have to find out the value of C now. So now to find the value of C, substitute this K value in any of these two equations. So 50 is equal to 100 into 0.496 plus C, either in this equation or in this equation. So 50 is equal to 12, that is 49.6 plus C. So your C will be equal to 0.4, that is 50 minus 49.6. So this your C answer is correct. Okay, so this is how the questions on the tachyometry, and this is a very very favorite question from the topic tachyometry. And the previous question which I have solved for sludge volume index, that was asked in this year only in PWD question paper. Okay, so that's all. These are my topics of the questions which I have solved from the paper 2019.